Welcome back, everybody, to another Q&A with Dr. J, who has a new painting behind her, which I really love. Florida Keys, beautiful. Anyway, today we are going to talk about the most popular gene on the planet. And what is that? It's the MTHFR responsible for methylation. And what is methylation responsible for in our body, Dr. J?
Yeah, I have a lot to say about this because MTHFR is so well known. If you know anything about genes, and if you've had your genes tested and you found out that you have the MTHFR gene variant, a lot of people just focus on that one gene. And again, it's not about the gene, it's about the enzyme. So to bring that into perspective, your genes are the blueprint to tell your body how to make an enzyme. And the MTHFR, the methylene tetrahydrofolate reductase, that's a
Yes.
mouthful. The ASE ending tells you it's an enzyme. So it's an enzyme, and its job is to convert folic acid that's often in our diet or supplements into something called methylfolate, which is the activated form of folic acid. And we've known about folic acid as a prevention for birth defects forever, right? Because doctors will always say if you're pregnant, take your folic acid because it can prevent birth defects, especially neurotube defects or spina bifida or cleft palate. That particular genetic variant can be associated with DNA damage. If you have a genetic variant there, you won't be repairing DNA damage as effectively. A lot of people that think they know what they know say, okay, if you have that genetic variant and you're homozygous, let's say there are two variants here that are most well studied, the C677T and the A1298C, they get their genes tested and they go, oh yeah, I have that variant. I should take methylfolate. But this is a very bad idea. I can tell you clinically that it's a very bad idea, and I've seen it happen to many people and myself as well. I had heterozygous MTHFR.
Tell
And
people what that means for people that don't
yes,
know.
so when you get your genes from your parents, you get one set from mom, one set from dad, and they combine to give you your blueprint for making these enzymes. We have base pairs. The DNA molecule has base pairs. The A and the T, C and the G connect to each other. But if you got the wrong code there from one parent, it's what we call heterozygous. You've got a lower functioning enzyme by about 30%. But if both parents gave you the wrong code, then it can reduce that enzyme by about 70%, which is a much bigger hit and much bigger impact on the body. And when you inherit that, then yes, you're going to be more at risk for birth defects if you get pregnant, but also you're not going to be able to repair your RNA and DNA correctly. And methylation, we've talked about it before, but basically it's a carbon and three hydrogen molecules, and it goes around to different other enzymes and upregulates them. So it's involved in a lot of other processing. One of the problems is when people take methylfolate thinking that, oh, I have that genetic variant, why don't I just take the product that's created from that enzyme? They start up all these processes. And one of the biggest processes is detoxification. And we're going to actually do another video on detoxification, but its job is to make glutathione and to upregulate detoxification in the body. So what it does is it stirs up all the toxins, but then you got to make sure that the pathways are open for them to get out. And that is where the problem is. And so people thinking that they're doing the right thing, they have the MTHFR variant, they've heard that they should take methylfolate, and doctors are prescribing it, and sometimes in really high doses, which I just cringe when I see it because I know they're headed for a world of trouble. A lot of people think that you have to suffer when you're detoxing,
I've heard that,
that you have headaches and you hurt all over and you're tired, and that's just what you have to deal with detoxification. I'm telling you're doing damage to the body, and we're going to talk more about that. But when you turn on that methylation pathway through taking methylfolate, you're dumping a bunch of toxins, chemicals, heavy metals, pesticides into the bloodstream. And now your liver and your kidneys and other pathways have to deal with it downstream. And if you have genetic variants downstream that are going to slow down your ability to get those out, you've just stirred up a hornet's nest. And Usually people feel really good for about a week and then the headaches will start and you hurt all over and you're nauseous and it feels terrible. I'm telling you firsthand. And we saw it in my clinic. We did a lot of research on this because we were all excited about the MTHFR and let's give people methylfolate who have that gene. And oh man, we saw some pretty awful detoxification symptoms and experienced them ourselves. And we went, what's going on? And then we would do urine tests. We would do what's a urine catch, basically. And we were seeing heavy metals coming out, even without turning on a detox program. So we knew that it was happening. But if you don't control that, it's going to do more damage in the long run because those metals can then get into your brain. They can get into your joints. It's got to go somewhere. It can be very painful and really awful.
I have seen any number of people on social media that are gurus, experts in this methylation world saying exactly what you're saying not to do. I'm sure that doesn't make you very happy to see these. Lots of people are following that advice. So this is what I meant to say at the beginning. This is why we wanted to cover this topic, is to sort out the myths from the facts and keep people safe.
Yeah, absolutely. And again, it's only one gene.
Yeah,
And
that's true.
I get really annoyed with people that go in after one gene and they don't understand the interplay of genes. And that's why with myhappygenes, we look at, okay, what's happening downstream? When you turn on methylation, which is actually a good thing to do, there's more to that story I want to talk about, but you got to make sure you understand what's going on down below, or otherwise you're going to hurt people. And when I see people on the internet talking about, oh, you have MTHFR, how much methylfolate should I take? I'm like, none. Not until you know what you're doing, because
Right,
you're actually
right.
going to create a bigger problem and hurt people. The other piece of this is methylfolate is one piece of a methylation cycle. So one side is B12 and the other side is folate, and they turn each other like knobs. So if you crank the folate and you don't get the B12 in there, you're actually going to create another problem. Just a deficiency of B12 can cause neurological problems, and the buildup of folate can actually become toxic. So you got to understand, you got to look at the whole picture. And so when we do the testing with myhappygenes, the software is going to look at that and say, oh, you've got more than just the MTHFR. You have the MTHFD, which is another enzyme in the methylfolate pathway, or you have the MTRR, or you have the PEMT. So there are other genes that can also contribute to low methylation. It isn't just one gene there that's doing this. So it's knowing what you're looking at, educating yourself. And if you try this, if you try a methylfolate and you start to get a headache, you got to back off because it's building up toxins in your bloodstream and it's going to create damage. You are damaging yourself. You're damaging your kidneys, you're damaging your liver, you're damaging your brain. And so when you turn on detoxification, you got to do it slow and steady because turns out we're exposed to toxins every day, every second of every day. You can't get away from it now. Maybe in the past we could have, but these are pesticides and chemicals that our DNA has never seen, our genes have.
Microplastics, that's another big topic lately. Microplastics are everywhere, right?
Totally.
Yeah.
So it's a dangerous thing. And so there are lots of ways to do it gently and turn it on so that you're detoxing all the time, just very slowly, so that you don't damage things. And
Like
that's,
the body was designed to do.
yeah, exactly.
Meh, she says.
What a thing. Yeah, so this, it's a big topic, and I cringe when I see doctors who are giving patients 1,000 DFE of methylfolate. The other thing that's, I'll just say it briefly here, but we look at cofactors. This enzyme's cofactor is riboflavin. So it's actually a little safer for somebody to do riboflavin to upregulate that enzyme's function gently. And so that can be a little safer. But again, it's one gene and we want to look at all of them.
And listeners, readers, watchers, Dr. J is not saying go get riboflavin if you find out you have MTHFR. Okay, just don't do anything unless you have somebody that knows what they're doing that can help you. And or if you're taking some kind of methylfolate product right now and it has helped you and you do feel better, take it, right?
Yeah, one in 1,000 will benefit from just doing that because their detox pathways are like open, rare, but they're like, I feel good, but it's rare.
Okay, if you are the rare person, congratulations. If you're not, and if you just found out you have MTHFR, because you did
THFR.
get MTH, whatever, all those letters put together,
Mother freaker.
the mother flipper gene. If you just found out that you have that because you have had your genes tested, but a company that isn't myhappygenes, find out what you can about how to treat, how to upregulate or downregulate that gene, probably by coming to us and getting your genes tested again. I don't know any other company that's using the algorithm that you created to specifically address this kind of thing.
Yeah, and knowing when it's safe to turn that methylation on, because it is important, but you got to make sure that everything is ready to go down below, and that's what our algorithm does.
And if anybody wants to know more about methylation specifically, we have a video on the channel that where it, I think the title is What is Methylation? Something like that. So Dr. J went into more of the enzyme process, that whole thing. So if you want more information, you can find it there. And if you want more information about all kinds of other genes, run over to myhappygenes.com, check out the blog, and consider getting your genes tested. If you have a desire to feel your best and you're just not, and or you've been to doctors and it's whack-a-mole, it's not this, it's not that, it's not. Genes narrow it down pretty clearly to what it could be.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, we'll be back with another Q&A, peeps. Don't forget, send us your questions. We would really love to have you be participants in these Q&A in this series. Be well till next time. Thanks, Dr. J.
Thanks, TC. Good to see you.